farmer's decision on what crop they're going to use within a growing season is one of the most important decisions they're going to make that season. And then over the long term is sort of a cornerstone of sustainability.
In today's world, we often use crop rotations as a convenient and ordered way to manage our cropping system. But Mark Liebig stands on the shoulders of giants as he looks at the long-term effects of dynamic cropping systems.
For our region, you know, our research has found that a dynamic cropping system is probably the most sustainable. Now, a dynamic cropping system, what is that? Well, it's an approach to crop sequencing where you're making decisions on what to plant every year. You can imagine that within a particular region, there's going to be a certain portfolio of crops that you can use. You have to take that information and you have to have a real detailed understanding about the short-term sequencing effects. You think about it. You think about a fixed rotation where you may have two heavy water using crops followed by one light water using crop. But that doesn't necessarily take into consideration what the conditions are in terms of the precip you're receiving. You might have a year where you didn't get any snowfall over the course of winter. It was an open winter and you're going into the spring completely dry. In a fixed sequence, well, you're going to plant that. Whereas for the dynamic cropping systems approach, what we can do is that we can look at our portfolio of crops and say, what's you going to use the less water? And will it fit in with the rotation based on what we have planted the previous year and the residue that's there? What's the market like for that crop? We've done a lot of that short-term research with some fantastic scientists who are here and retired just recently, looking at those short-term effects. And they also set experiments in place where we could look at the dynamic cropping system over the long term. And what we've found is that if we use spring wheat as sort of our keystone crop, we find that its yields are 20% higher under a dynamic cropping system versus, say, like a three-year fixed rotation. And so there's the production component, and you can look at the soil health, and what we see is we see higher organic matter content. We see faster infiltration rates under that dynamic cropping system compared to the fixed system. And so you're seeing soil health benefits starting to accrue from that approach as well. And so we kind of see that the dynamic cropping system is a sort of a win-win for producers. So you've got the production component, production's higher yields, and you're also improving the soil resource, which is sort of, that's the long-term sustainability component.